So this study, which I will be talking about, which was presented by our postdoc, Dr. Mohamed Gouda, as a mini-oral presentation as a part of the ESMO program, is an analysis of activity and safety and circulating tumor DNA dynamics of paradox breaker BRAF inhibitor called PLX8394 in patients with advanced cancers. PLX8394 is a second generation of BRAF inhibitor, which is distinctly different from first generation BRAF inhibitors such as dabrafenib, vemurafenib, or encorafenib. First generation BRAF inhibitors typically inhibit BRAF, monomerically activated BRAF, which is typically by the BRAF V600 mutation, and are actually quite ineffective in patients who have other BRAF mutation, which result in the dimeric activation of the pathway. PLX8394, which actually doesn't cause paradoxical activation of the MAP kinase pathway, has, in addition to efficacy on the monomeric BRAF activation, also efficacy on the dimeric BRAF activation. It can be effective in addition to BRAF V600 mutation, also in circumstances when patients have BRAF fusions or activating BRAF mutations, which can lead to dimeric activation of the pathway. So in this study, we presented results, efficacy results on 69 patients. Vast majority of these patients had actually some form of BRAF mutation, which 43 patients had V600 BRAF mutation, and 17 patients had non-V600 activating BRAF mutations, which were mostly exon 11 mutations, but also a few patients, but there were also actually a patient with fusion. So we just briefly summarized the data, which have been already shared before. The recommended phase 2 dose was 900 milligrams twice a day. We also pointed out that during the drug development of this paradox breaker BRAF inhibitor, we also noticed that the exposure of PLX8394 in pharmacokinetic studies can be substantially increased if PLX8394 is co-administered with cabazitaxel, which is CYP3A4 inhibitor, which is used in the treatment of HIV. And therefore, a substantial proportion of patients in this study received actually a combination of PLX8394 and cabazitaxel in order to improve pharmacokinetic features. The adverse events profile was actually quite mild, and most adverse events were grade 1 or grade 2, including transaminitis, elevation of bilirubin, diarrhea, nausea, vomiting, and fatigue. And there were only a handful of grade 3 or more ALT or AST or bilirubin elevations or diarrhea. So from that point of view, the side effect profile of this drug was actually very favorable compared to the other drugs in the class. We have seen quite an interesting signals of activity, quite a lot of interesting signals of activity, including 10 partial responses in 52 patients with evaluable disease by imaging. And most of these responses were actually in patients with BRAF mutations, and probably most of them had actually BRAF V600E mutation. Although we also seen quite significant partial response in a patient with BRAF fusion and melanoma. Again, BRAF fusions are not responsive to first generation BRAF inhibitors. The responses were durable and lasted for often up to multiple months. And the patient with the BRAF fusion, who has arguably actually even a complete response with 100% reduction in the target lesions, is actually on therapy for 26 plus months. We also studied dynamics of circulating tumor DNA using next generation sequencing and droplet digital PCR. And to summarize the data from liquid biopsies, we were essentially trying to answer the question whether the liquid biopsy can actually serve as a tool to further narrow and predict the response to therapy. And we detected that using the next-generation sequencing in plasma, we can actually detect the broad spectrum of mutation and that can correlate with the tumor response. The dynamics in that can actually correlate with the tumor response, or in other words, changes in the clonal evolution and the quantity of mutant DNA correlate with the tumor response. We also noticed using the droplet digital PCR that variant allele frequency for the mutant DNA in the circulating tumor DNA is actually higher in patients who progressed versus patients who did not, and that applied to the all time points, which were serially collected while on study. We also noticed that progression-free survival was shorter in patients with detectable BRAF mutation in ctDNA, which is somewhat counterintuitive because BRAF is a target for BRAF inhibitor, but in fact, we actually seen that patients who were known to be BRAF mutated in the tissue, but we were not able to detect a BRAF mutation in the circulating tumor DNA. So in a way, for ctDNA, they were falsely negative. So these patients actually, in fact, do better. And that's an observation which has been reported previously from other independent studies by my group, as well as others. And we also noticed that CT progression or the increase in the ctDNA quantity either preceded or co-occurred with clinical and radiological progression, which makes it as a plausible tool to identify or even predict disease progression. However, this will need to be studied in the further studies.